So we will now write some programs to understand the concept of a dynamic constructor. Okay. So for that, let us create a class. The name is suppose XYZ, and here we create a pointer const char star p. So p is a pointer, and this pointer will contain the address of a character, and that character is constant. Means we will not change the value which is pointed to by this pointer p. Okay, so if the memory location contains character x, then it will remain x throughout this program. So this character is a constant character. Okay, so this is the only data object which we have. Then in the public section, let us create a constructor XYZ. It has got no arguments. It means this is the default constructor. Okay. And here we are going to create the dynamic constructor. It means that we are going to allocate memory dynamically. How to allocate memory dynamically? Using the new operator. Okay. So P is equal to new. Okay. So memory is allocated using new operator. P will contain the address which is returned by the new operator. Okay, so whose address is returned by the new operator? By the block of memory which is allocated. Okay, so let us allocate the memory equal to 5 characters. Okay, so p equal to new char 5 means new operator will allocate memory somewhere equal to the size occupied by 5 characters. It will accommodate 5 characters. And the base address will be stored in P. Okay, so we are using the dynamic constructor here because we are using the new keyword. Okay, and now let us put some value inside this. So P is equal to, suppose it is equal to 5 characters SLI. Let's make it 6. Okay. So this is the value which this character string. This is called, this is a character array. This is also called a string. Okay. And when we are assigning the values to a string, then we write the values inside the double inverted commas. Okay. So p equal to slight means the value at p is equal to slight. Okay. And here we do not need to write the star operator because the name of the now let us write another member function void display. Here we will show the value which is there in p, cout p. Okay. So this is our class. Now in the main function, let us create an object of this class XYZX. Okay, so an object has been created with this. When this statement will be executed, the constructor will run automatically, and constructor will allocate memory equal to 6 characters. So and this 6 characters will contain the value slight. Okay, so now let us try to print this value x dot display. So using this member function, we can access the value which is stored at display, return 0. Let us try to run it. There is a spelling mistake. Okay. So it is displaying the value slide, which we stored in the character string. Okay. So because we were using this new operator here, memory will be allocated only when we are running this program, and that is why this is called the dynamic constructor. Okay. So now let us try to change this. Let us take another example. Let us have int star p. Okay. And p is equal to new int. Okay. So the memory will be allocated here equal to the size of an integer, and the value at this that integer will be equal to 0. Okay. So this is a dynamic constructor. Can we have multiple dynamic constructors? Yes, we can have. Suppose we have another dynamic constructor xyz p is equal to new int. So this is also allocating memory equal to the size of a integer. Let us make this constructor parameterized by taking a parameter x, and suppose the value at p is equal to x. So the value will be equal to the value which we pass as argument to this constructor. Okay, and this will be same cout. Here we need to put a asterisk. Okay. Here xyz x, x dot display. So which constructor will be called? The default constructor will be called, and memory equal to one integer will be allocated, and that will be equal to 0. Okay, let us create another constructor xyz x2. Okay, and write, because x2 is a parameterized constructor, we have to pass a value, suppose 10. 10 will be copied to this formal parameter x, and then this x will be the value pointed to by p. Okay, so x2 dot display. Let's check it. So it is 0 for the first constructor and 10 for the second constructor. Okay. Now, instead of allocating memory to a single integer, let us make it equal to, suppose, 3 integers. Okay. And we can assign the values using the curly braces. 1, 2, 3 are the values which will be placed in the memory allocated to this block. Okay. So, what are we doing in this statement? New memory is allocated equal to 3 integers, and the values in those 3 integers will be 1, 2 and 3 respectively. Okay, and here we do not need to write this. Let us remove this. So we have only one constructor here, and for displaying the values we need a for loop, because this is an array. Int I equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus, C out. We can write P I. Okay. So here, let's try to run this and also put an endian for a cleaner output. 1, 2, 3. Okay.